الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه من والاه، وبعد. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أم سلمة رضي الله عنها, the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, once asked, I said to the Prophet, why is it that we are not mentioned in the Quran as men are? Then one day, without me realizing it, he was calling from the minbar and I was combing my hair. So I tied my hair and then I went out to my chamber, to the chamber of my house, and I started listening out. And he was calling from the minbar, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And at this point of time, he was calling from the minbar the following ayah of the Holy Quran: Inna al-Muslimin wal-Muslimat, wal-Mu'minin wal-Mu'minat, wal-Qanitin wal-Qanitat, wal-Sadiqin wal-Sadiqat, wal-Sabirin wal-Sabirat, wal-Khashi'in wal-Khashi'at, wal-Mutasaddiqin wal-Mutasaddiqat, wal-Sa'imin والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجر عظيمة. This verse was revealed in connection as an answer to the question of the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أم سلمة رضي الله عنها. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says in translating this verse, verily the Muslim men and women, the believers, men and women, the men and women who are obedient, the men and women who are truthful, the men and women who are patient, the men and women who are humble, the men and women who observe fasting, the men and women who guard their chastity, and the men and women who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for them a forgiveness and a great reward. This is kind of the criteria Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks for when it comes to a believing person. This verse shows us that Islam has been revealed to all human beings, regardless of race, gender, or any other different. And this verse clarifies a lot of things and how it is their equal responsibility. Whether you're a brother or you're a sister, it is our responsibility to be devout, to serve our religion. This is our responsibility. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in kind of breaking up this verse, he says, verily the men and women, the Muslim men and women, this is the first criteria, the Muslim men and women, the Muslim meaning the one who submits to the will of his creator, and the believers, men and women, they submit, and the believer is actually the next level up. It is those who put their faith practically into their action, and the men and women who are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all aspects of life. They put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. They give preference to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before anyone. Those who are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The men and women who are truthful, they are truthful to their religion, they are truthful to their actions, and they are truthful in their speech. They're truthful in every single thing they do. The men and women who are patient when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's obedience. They are patient when it comes to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are patient when it comes to any form of calamity. They are patient. The men and women who are humble, they show humility. They're humble in their personality. They're humble in their salah and their prayers. When they stand in front of their Lord, they don't stand in an arrogant manner. When they serve their Lord, they don't serve their Lord, or they don't walk on the face of this earth in an arrogant manner. The men and women who observe a sawm, they observe fasting. They fast in the month of Ramadan, and they perform voluntary fasts. The men and women who guard their chastity. Now, guarding the chastity, brothers and sisters, are included in all aspects. Not only guarding the chastity means that preventing a person, saving oneself from committing illegal sexual intercourse, but guarding chastity comes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not even go near zina. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah didn't say in the Quran that do not perform zina, but he said don't even go near it. Look at today, our brothers and sisters, how many of them are lost chatting and joking with the opposite sex? Whether on the internet, whether at school, whether in the office, whether in the mixed parties, and all of these things, we are not following those who guard their chastity, who have haya, who have shyness, who have modesty. We are losing this very important characteristic of a believer. And the men and women, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues, and the men and women who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much. They remember Allah in their hearts. They remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on their tongues. They call other people towards Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for them forgiveness and a great reward. So one of the things that we learn in all of these qualities is that Allah has prepared for them forgiveness and a great reward. Forgiveness showing us that in order for us to obtain the forgiveness of Allah, for Allah to forgive us for our years and years of darkness, for our years and years of sins, we have to follow it up with practical action. And it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has prepared for them a great reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after this beautiful verse in Surah Al-Ahzab, verse number 35, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues in the next verse, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَن يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا مُبِينًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is not for a believer, man or woman, when Allah and His Messenger have decreed a matter, that they should have any option in their decision. And whosoever disobeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger has indeed strayed in a plain error. They don't have any choice. They listen and they obey. This is the primary characteristic of the believer. This is the importance of submitting to Allah in our hearts, on the tongues, the words that we say, and in our actions. I'm giving this a practical meaning. Practically in our day-to-day life, you and I should ask ourselves, how much do we remember Allah? Practically in our day-to-day lives, before we perform any action, how many times do we think that this action I'm going to perform, is it pleasing to Allah or not? Did Allah make this permissible or not? How many times in our day-to-day affairs are we able to control our desires? Are we able to control our lusts? Are we able to control our love for money? How many times in our day-to-day affairs, especially for the brothers, are they able to control themselves when it comes to affairs related to the opposite sex? These are important questions that you and I must ask one another. Look at the verse, the strength of the verse. Allah says they do not even have any option to their decision. They don't have a third option. How many things are we doing in our religion today that have not been confirmed to us by Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam? And this was the two verses today which I basically had the chance of touching, of literally scratching the surface of these two verses. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He makes us obedient to Him. That, you know, brothers and sisters, just before I let you go, if a person, he makes sincere dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to become obedient, to earn Allah's pleasure, to do actions that are pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the way easy for that person. A person must have enthusiasm, a person must have a sincere intention, and a person must make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because brothers and sisters, in reality, if we live a life of obedience to Allah and His Messenger, this is the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give to any individual. We spend so much time innovating in our religion, celebrating the birthday of the Prophet, doing many things. Look at the birthday of the Prophet, the Milad al-Nabi. Neither did the Prophet, neither did his companions, neither did the Tabi'een. Nobody ever practiced this. This was practiced. This practice started 400 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not one or two days. 400 years. Instead of us, as a sincere and humble advice, instead of us spending our time doing things that wasn't even ordered to us to do, just doing things for no reason, instead of us wasting our efforts over there, why don't we spend and invest our efforts in loving the Prophet? Why don't we show our love to the Prophet the way his companions showed love to him? And it is important, brothers and sisters, that we realize this fact, and I wish I had more time to spend enumerating on this, but we have to end, inshallah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.